Welcome back to another episode of the Switch Survival Guide. Today we are going to build one of my specialties, which is the Armored Raft. Now, we're just going to lay the foundation on this episode, and then in the next episodes we're going to teach you how to actually build it into a mobile taming pen that you can use to tame really dangerous and hard to tame dinosaurs. Now, this foundation is sunken into the raft base, and it completely covers the raft, so if it's made of wood, the raft will be very tough, but we can later replace it with stone and the raft will be completely impervious to dinosaurs. Now, I'm also going to show you a really quick way to gather a ton of materials, so if you're not interested in seeing that, just skip to about 3 minutes into this video and we'll start building the raft right away. But real quick, I'm going to show you what I did to gather all the materials we needed for the raft and all the wooden foundations. There's a lot of materials you need for that. Now, I'm doing this on 2x gathering speed, but still, this is a pretty quick way to do it. So I've got 2 parasaurs and a triceratops, and everything's on follow. Now, this trike can knock over trees in no time at all, and it gets tons of thatch and a pretty good amount of wood, too. But he's got pretty low stamina and reasonably low weight. So I've knocked over a bunch of trees, I got about 300 thatch and a bunch of wood, so I'm going to open up my inventory and I'm actually going to craft the wooden foundations, walls, ramps, and all that stuff that I need right from the inventory of these dinos. So, pardon my mouse, I'm playing this on PC so that we can have a really clear, good-looking video quality, because the Switch definitely decreases the quality of the graphics so that it can keep up with such a small platform. I've had quite a few people say, oh my gosh, you're playing on Xbox. I'm actually playing on PC. It just displays Xbox buttons on my hotbar. So, just a heads up to anybody else who was wondering. So, I'm crafting a bunch of wooden foundations, which are heavy, way too heavy for me to carry. So I'm dropping those into my parasaur's inventory because he can carry about 550 pounds. And if he runs out of space, I've got my other parasaur that I can also load up. So that's going to be really helpful, and I can just level this entire forest area. And I'm going to do that because it is going to make a nice clearing where I can see if any predators are coming from this direction. It's actually a really good defense mechanism to clear out the forest so that you can see a long distance, because one of the best ways to avoid getting eaten is to see a predator coming. So we've cleared out a good chunk of the forest around here, and I brought all my dinos down to the beach, and we are just about ready to start building the raft. So the first thing I need to do is actually make the raft itself. So it's going to take like 250 wood, something like 75 hide, and a whole bunch of fiber, I think over 100. Anyway, it is a lot of materials, and a lot of very heavy materials. And the raft itself is quite heavy too, so I'm going to go ahead and craft that, but I brought my parasaur right down to the edge of the ocean so that I don't even have to move once this finishes crafting, because I'm probably not going to be able to move at that point. And here we go. Yep, I can't move at all. So I'm right here, and in order to place a raft, it's just like placing a foundation, only when you use it from your hotbar, it will immediately appear in the water, and you can only use it when you're pointing at the water. Now, sometimes it takes a couple of tries, just keep using it in your hotbar while you're pointing at the water until it actually appears in the water. So it could take a second, might take a couple tries, but just, you know, move around aiming at the water until it decides it's the right depth, and then the raft will appear. So there we go. Now, we have this really cool raft. You can actually build on the deck of this raft and lay foundations. But if we point at the rudder itself, that's how we can hit the X button to jump on the raft. And the raft will go in water, it'll even go in very shallow water, so you can beach it most of the way. It doesn't take any stamina or fuel, so you can keep moving quickly without ever having to stop at any point. And it has a really wide turn radius, so it takes some getting used to. It also kind of glides a little bit even when you stop moving, so just play around with that. Now, that sail is really in the way, so I'm going to hold down the X button and go to Options, and from here I can hit Hide Sail, and that will make the sail just disappear. Much better. So now, we have a nice empty deck that we can actually start building on. So I'm going to try to maneuver this to a good spot where we've got some depth, but I can actually hop on from the shore. So it takes a little maneuvering sometimes to get it at a good depth, but we do not want these foundations that we're placing to try to snap to the bottom of the ocean. So there we go. We've got, I'm trying to pull my dinosaur really close to the raft because we're going to go back and forth to its inventory quite a few times because I can't carry anywhere near all of the stuff. So every time you see me pop over to it, I'm just going to be, you know, grabbing more stuff, putting things away that I don't need. So we'll just skip that part. You don't need to see that. So I'm going to move this where it's reasonably deep, but this is a great place to build a raft because there's no way a whale can get into this section. And if a whale, a lead Cichthys, gets to you and it can hit your raft 6 times, the whole thing will sink, no matter how well armored it is. So keep that in mind. You are taking your life into your hands. So I've got my pillar out and I use the rudder, and once you jump on the raft, it centers your screen into the very center of the raft. So I kept going just straight up and down while I was looking until that went to the very center of the raft. And now my foundations will snap to either side of that pillar. But as you can see here, it is actually snapped a little bit below the deck. So this is a normal snap point, and it's just, you know, 6 inches or so below where that normal snap point is because it's trying to snap to the pillar. Now, when you snap a foundation to a pillar, it actually steps down just a little step. So I'm going to place another pillar there and demolish this pillar here in the middle. And now, if I place another foundation, it steps another step below that first foundation. So each time we're doing this, it's actually stepping down just a little bit. Now, there is a really cool feature that just got added to the PC version. I don't know if you're going to have this, so I'll assume you probably don't yet on the Switch, but they now have a thing where you can actually pick something up for 30 seconds after you've placed it down without having to destroy it, which is a great feature, but I'll do this as if we don't have that so you can get a good feel for it. So I keep placing a pillar and then demolishing the pillar and the foundation, then we stick another pillar inside the foundation, and then when we snap a foundation to that, it's going to be one step lower each time we do this. So we're pretty close to the edge of the deck, but as you can see here, the bottoms of the foundation are still not quite sticking through the bottom of the raft. Now, I almost got eaten by a piranha, so yeah, you can see him swimming by right there. It's a little dangerous here. So one more step down with a foundation should be just about perfect. As you can see, it is just barely sticking up from the top of that raft. And that's right where we want it. If we put it one more foundation lower, it's actually going to stick into the bottom of the raft and it won't protect the top. So this spot right here, just above the surface, is actually going to have the foundation extending past the bottom of the raft and above the top of the raft, so that either way, nothing can hurt this raft itself, and the foundations will take all the damage. Now, I've been using thatch foundations because they're really cheap to make and it's not such a big loss when we keep making a foundation and then demolishing it. But now that we've got this at the right spot, I'm going to start actually filling in foundations with wooden foundations, which cost a lot more. So it's real important to get it to the right level, but once we have one foundation in the right level, all of the wooden foundations will snap to that foundation. So I just grabbed a bunch of wooden foundations here, and I'm going to drag those into my hotbar. Once again, pardon my mouse, it just moves a lot faster that way. And as you can see here, this foundation snapped perfectly into the right spot, and it's completely covering the top and bottom of the raft. So the raft itself is sandwiched between the foundations. And now anything that tries to attack the raft from that corner will only hit the wooden foundation, and the raft will take no damage at all. Now, if you put a wooden foundation directly on top of a thatch foundation, it will just straight up replace it and demolish the thatch. Now, we'll be using this to our advantage because later we're going to actually replace all of these wooden foundations with stone. And when we do that, only alpha predators will be able to possibly damage our raft. So it becomes almost invincible at that point. Now, I'm going to place one more foundation here, and as you can see on this next spot, if I put another foundation there, it's actually going to cover up the rudder, and we need to be able to access the rudder in order to steer this ship. So, as you can see here, it's trying to snap to the foundation that's right next to that pillar. So, it's kind of hard to do that if you put a foundation there. So, I'm going to go ahead and pick up this foundation. And normally you would do this with thatch on this corner, but I'm going to snap this foundation to the side of that pillar, which will make it step down one more lower. And as you can see there, it's actually below the raft itself. So, I'm going to try to make that happen. And it's a little tricky sometimes. You gotta hit the top right bumper to make it switch between snap points, and it's trying to decide if it wants to snap to the pillar or the foundation next to it. But there we go. So now the entire rudder is still exposed, and I can still hop on and off and drive the raft. Whereas if I had stepped it on the level was one above that it was trying to snap to, it would actually cover the rudder and I could not steer the raft. So I'm going to put foundations down on either side of that one in the back, and I'll go ahead and demolish this wooden pillar so it's not in the way. And by doing that, we've only got one tiny spot where the raft is actually exposed. But on the next episode, when we build our taming pen, we're actually going to make a little house around the rudder, so that will also be completely covered. So there we go. We have a totally covered foundation. Nothing can possibly hurt us from the bottom, and nothing can hurt the raft from the top unless it demolishes those wooden foundations. So that's going to be a very nice and safe foundation base. Now, the next thing, we're going to pick up some ramps because it's actually impossible to jump up onto these foundations from the water at this point. And you got to be real careful because if you take this out into the water and then fall off, it's impossible to get back on. So ramps are very important to add before you actually take this raft anywhere because you can walk up the ramp and get up the water. So I'm going to move this into slightly deeper water again. Once again, this is a great spot to build. This is right next to where you first spawn as the default spawn point, and it's right below our cliff base too. So I'm going to try to snap this to the other one. There we go. And now, if we get in the water, we can just run up the ramp, and then we can access this raft. So that's always really important to have a plan in case you fall off your raft. So we have this nice little foundation. It's 3x3. It's still kind of small. So I actually want to make this even bigger so that we can have enough room to place our dinosaurs on the deck, because pretty soon I'm going to show you this magical island that has no predators on it. It's amazing. But for now, I want to make this bigger, and as you can see, I cannot snap any more foundations on because there's no more deck on the raft itself. But we have a workaround. If I place a thatch ceiling off the edge, it'll snap to that first foundation, and then I can snap a foundation to the bottom of that thatch ceiling. It's weird, I know, but it actually works. And then after I add these three foundations, I'm actually going to be able to remove the thatch ceilings, and it'll keep that as part of the deck. Now, if you're too close to the bottom, that will happen. I didn't actually lose that wooden foundation, but it's just refusing to snap because it doesn't have enough room between the bottom of the ocean and the top of that ceiling. So I just need to move into slightly deeper water, and once again trying to avoid the piranhas, but if I can aim this just right, there we go. We now have a foundation snapped underneath that ceiling, and I can demolish these ceilings. Now, if you have this new update, you can actually pick it up instead of demolishing it if you're fast enough, so definitely keep that in mind. But there we go, so we've demolished these thatch foundations, and this is now going to be a perfect 3x4 deck that we can build off of. And we'll continue to extend this in the next episode, but in the next episode I'm going to actually build a mobile taming pen, and we'll build a little structure that we can get wild dinosaurs trapped on. We can pull it up to the beach anywhere, lure a dinosaur to hop into the cage, and then tame it while it's still trying to break out of the wooden foundations. So this will be really helpful, and be sure to watch the next episode to see that technique. Or, if you want, you can just build a base on top of this kind of a structure and live on the ocean, as long as you watch out for whales. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time! Thanks so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please like this video and subscribe to our channel so we can bring you more great guides like this one. Ark is an amazing game, but there is so much to learn before you can really enjoy it. We are dedicated to bringing you high-quality guides, tutorials, and Let's Play videos that are fun, helpful, clean, and suitable for the entire family. There's a tutorial in this series for everything we have done so far in this video. Check out these playlists for more episodes from this series and other guides to help you enjoy your journey on Ark.